Uh-oh. It's coming out.
I'm about to start rapping. Ready? You ready?
My actual government name is Danilo Diocampo, but my mother calls me Jonah.
I don't give a shit if you get offended by any other words you hear me saying on the record. I don't give a second shit if you feel disrespected. I hate commentary in a second, I forget it. I mean, in the big scheme of things, anything, you whatever's opinion and what I'ma do. You made up your mind, don't be fucking my mind, and I'ma run up behind you with a blind 1-2 punch you in the cheekbone, shatter in your jawbone, talking on your cell phone like you ain't know. Sitting on the concrete, screaming what I do. You was talking too much shit about Bambo.
Now I go by the moniker Bamboo.
I ain't got a problem with the difference of opinion on a topic that I cover on a song on an album. Maybe because you voted for the fucker that I'm clowning. Maybe you ain't fond of the way the music is sounding. Whatever, Holmes, I don't spit into the microphone unless I know this shit is getting my teeth thumped. So get out my face without a hater ass junk. Put it on you bloody in a driver's seat slump. Starting a Suburban on, maybe it's a German car, maybe it's a certain car I ain't never seen. Either way, it's obvious you should keep your mouth shut or I'll make your four wheels lean, you know what I mean?
Native gun, straight bullet. Yeah. The yeah. Bamboo, uh-huh. Yeah. 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 I get at it. Straight bullets stay hooded down in tribal Pinoy. Leave an impressing impression like a skin keloid. Watts did it, been hitting since OFTB. Cam did it, now Bam did it like
OFPD.
They say y'all rap about the same shit, politics and police. But I just do what I do, homie, y'all know me. Perfected my style, rejected your style. You don't like it? High middle finger and smile. So many people have so many expectations of me. But you ain't never been around the same shit as the B. AMBU, I hold pistols peaceful, but I can flip too and send a whole clip of pellets to me.
We are in we're San Jose State University. We're on the Native Guns tour right now. Hitting up every college that we possibly can. Right now we're definitely like as independent as you can get. I mean, every scent that we make off the Barrowman album goes right back into the next batch, or it goes right back into the music, or goes into paying for our own flight sometimes. You know what I'm saying? Hey, good job, y'all.
Good job, good job, good job.
Good job, good job, y'all.
Nice. Little singer, little John Legend right there. You know, that's us when we was little kids. Like, we need to raise the next generation of soldiers, you know? So if it takes me getting on a little jiggy beat and throwing down to get them to listen and find a bridge, you know what I'm saying? Find a bridge between us and the struggle back home and the struggles all over the, you know, all over the world with indigenous people. So then that's what I gotta do.
It's time to get jumped in. This is your initiation. Since you are now rolling with the Barrowman, friend, it's the soundtrack music for the grassroots movement. A nonviolent resistance with a click for the bullets of music. I like fire through the EDs too. It's the sound that my Ohio folks do outreach to. It's the shit my KMP cause I must mobilize to. Are you college kids who wanna up and organize too? Soon as they hear the music, I'll be on the ride out too. The songs that my gorillas know they all my life too. But I eat all of your army for God's sake, so I think familia na hindi sila magiging biktima ni Gloria. O kung sino man ay ilalagay sa silya niya, hanggang walang respeto sa aming mga kasama at kababayan Pilipino. Hindi kami uulo, tutulong kami regardless of a foreign and we move on hanggat humihinga itong dalawang taga Bisaya. Lalaban na talaban sa ubos na ang aming bala. Para sa mga kaibigan at mga kasama, lahat ng mga bata at saka mga matanda. Para sa masa, hindi lang basta bahala. It isn't just a gimmick when we yell and
Maki Baka.
From the inside of a cage, the hate they
wake up, we straight slaves.
Who says you gotta break a dollar to make change? Do what you gotta do,
whatever it takes, man.
Like a third string quarterback,
fool, he ain't playing.
Whether here or back home, they saying the same thing.
We take aim at the side of your dome,
like a paradigm just running up inside of your home
and hit you like I'm Rock
with a plutonium elbow and knock you straight out of your shell. So
let me tell you,
the time is now, the youth are hungry, but the world ain't ready, the truth is ugly, but the truth is all I got, ain't no taking it from it, so we shaking it, taking it, making it funky.
Make some noise and hey.
People were already telling me, yo, you gotta hear this Kiwi kid, you know, already making comparisons to me and Kiwi, like, you're kinda like that Kiwi dude, you know, you be talking about kinda the same spit, man, you need to meet up with that guy, but he had moved to the Bay Area at the time. And, you know, my young 23-year-old ass, I'm walking around going, fuck that dude, you know what I mean? Like, I spit better than that cat, never hearing his music, I just assumed I was gonna be better than Kiwi. And I finally heard his music, and I was like, nah, he's nice. you know, one of those under the breath, like, shit, you know, I gotta really bring it now, you know. We started seeing each other on the circuit more, and I asked him to be on a song called Peaceful Pistols on my first album, and, you know, that was it. Native Guns really started as a tour name. It was, let's call it the Native Guns Tour. Bamboo and Kiwi, and then just go on the road together. And then it just natural progression, and just started to bleed, and eventually, well, I don't even think it was discussed, like, let's make a Native Guns crew. It just became that way.
Look at sentimental ass over here.
Can you keep this so I can hang it on my wall?
Then we brought Chinese guy, the DJ, the butt of our jokes, but I love him to death.
Damn shit stain from 2 weeks ago still is on my toilet. I tried pissing it off and everything. That shit's like kryptonite, man. He is Superman.
DJ Fatrick is now, you know, a part of the crew, and now I feel like we're complete.
Guns pointed, hammers back, where all of my soldiers at? Yellow, brown, red, black, break yourself up out the trap. Learn your facts, open your eyes, counterattack, organize, mobilize, plant seeds.
My knowledge of the Filipino culture was very limited because we grew up in a predominantly black neighborhood. You know, I didn't come to this epiphany of, oh my God, I'm Filipino, I need to embrace my culture. That didn't happen for me for a long time. You know, it's still happening for me. You know, this country robs us of our culture. It doesn't promote that. You know, so when hip hop came out and said, be proud of who you are, you know, that to me was like, wow, well, there's got to be so much more. It was difficult trying to figure out who I was. I didn't have an elder I could go talk to. You know, my mother left me at a very young age. My father was gone out of my life. So I spent a lot of nights out in the street. You know, I didn't have anywhere to go. I had just got out of jail. I wasn't doing shit with my life, you know. I was rapping, but I didn't have any direction. So I joined the military. I mean, it was the only thing for a young man to do. I felt, you know, that college was not an option. I didn't have any money. At about 19, I'm living in Japan. I'm in Okinawa. And there'd be Filipino women jacking off servicemen, you know, look like my sister. They look like kids I grew up with on the block. You know, seeing white Marines coming into the barracks, talking about things that they would do, or they would make the accent. I would automatically think about my mother, like, that's my mom saying these things. And so those things really started to help me get politicized. And going out into the city and seeing the protests that Okinawan locals were having against the military really was like, well, I need to know what is really going on here, you know. I could have gone either way, and I've seen a lot of cats get engulfed in that, you know, sir, yes, sir, and they become these, you know, flag-waving American boys. And I went the complete opposite direction.